I do want to say before we get to our next guest that I have been in contact with the Trump Minnesota campaign all week, and we were hoping as late as last Friday, or Friday 2 days ago, to have a prominent Minnesota Trump supporter on this show. That did not work out, and I do want everyone to know that the Trump campaign does have an open invitation to come on at a later date. But we do have the national campaign manager for the Hillary Clinton campaign, Robbie Mook. Thank you so much for coming on.
Thanks. It's great to be here.
All right. Let me ask you, what are you doing here in Minnesota? Are you folks concerned about this state? It hasn't gone for a Republican since 1972 in the presidential race.
Well, we feel good about how we're doing here right now. We feel great about the organization. Lots of really enthusiastic volunteers that I've been seeing as I'm here. But we don't want to take anything for granted here in Minnesota or anywhere in the country. We actually have staff in all 50 states. We've made a big investment in talking directly to voters here and around the country. And so that's why I'm here, just to make sure that everything's running on all cylinders.
All right. And as I mentioned with Senator Franken a few minutes ago, Bernie Sanders killed Hillary Clinton here in this state, 62-37% in the caucuses. What is that? Are you concerned about that, that there might be an enthusiasm gap that remains?
I'm not that concerned. First and foremost, the public polling that's out there shows that Senator Sanders supporters are overwhelmingly supporting Secretary Clinton. And Senator Sanders has been a really valuable asset to our campaign and a really great partner. He delivered an incredible endorsement speech in New Hampshire, and then obviously at the convention, we've been working very closely with him. And he's going to be an important part of turning out our vote here in Minnesota. Minnesota is actually the first state in the country to start voting. He and his supporters will be really important partners in getting people out.
Your campaign has been plagued by this continued drip about the emails, 15,000 additional ones in the past week. Julian Assange saying that there's going to be an additional leak right before the election. How concerned are you about that, and should Clinton supporters be worried? Do you know what Assange is going to leak?
Well, we don't, but I think voters are wise to what's going on here. We know that Russian state actors broke into the DNC, and we now hear that they've broken into the Democratic Governors Association, the Democratic Congressional Campaign Committee, and they're leaking information for the purpose of hurting Democrats. It's very clear that
the information isn't very flattering,
well,
frankly.
That's because the hand of the Kremlin is at work in this campaign. They've picked a side. They want to elect Donald Trump, and they're doing everything they can to hurt Hillary Clinton and other Democrats. I don't think voters here in Minnesota or anywhere in the country want the Russians dictating what's going on here. So I think voters are looking past this and looking through it. And they're also, look, what they care about is what candidates are going to do to get this economy working for them. They don't care about all this process. But look, it's very troubling that the Russians are at work here and that Donald Trump
refuses to... Well, the emails themselves, though, to a lot of people are troubling. And Mrs. Clinton's response saying that, quote, she had short-circuited when she told Chris Wallace of Fox News that FBI director had given her sort of a clean bill of health on this. I mean, so I think a lot of people are still troubled by that.
Well, look, Secretary Clinton has said she needs to earn the trust of the voters in this election. She's working hard to do that. She said this email setup was a mistake. She said if she can go back, she'd do it differently. She's apologized. But the voters have the information about this now, and I think at this point they really want to learn more about what these two candidates are going to do to actually help them in their lives.
All right. And I think they also want to learn more about her. Why aren't you putting her out there in news conferences? This is a very intelligent woman. People who know her well, as I'm sure you do, say the more you get to know her, the more you like her. Yet your campaign is not putting her out there. Why not?
Well, we are. She's done over 300 interviews this year alone. She's answered a myriad of different questions in settings just like we're having right now. So she's absolutely out there. We've had her speak to groups of reporters one-on-one. We're going to continue to look at all the different options, but we're really proud of the over 300 interviews she's already done. We're going to do a lot more.
Okay. Minnesota has a history of going for third-party candidates or having large numbers of voters go for third-party candidates. If you look at some of the polls in Iowa, for example, Secretary Clinton's lead shrinks when you factor in Jill Stein, the Green Party candidate, and Gary Johnson, the Libertarian Party candidate. How big a deal is this here?
Well, we don't fully know. I think after Labor Day, we'll have a better sense of the dynamics of the race. Typically, what we find is that these candidates perform at a fraction, on Election Day, a fraction of what they do in the polls. So it's important to keep that in mind. But look, I think the voters understand there's two major candidates in this race, Donald Trump and Secretary Clinton. You probably have the most qualified person in Secretary Clinton to ever seek the presidency in our history. Donald Trump's probably the most unfit person to ever seek the presidency. This man cannot become our commander-in-chief, and that's why I'm confident people are going to come, turn out, and support Secretary Clinton.
Well, Robbie Mook, the national campaign manager for Hillary Clinton, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. And again,
so
folks, we are hoping to have a prominent Minnesota Trump supporter on a show in the very near future. We want to